गुड
मॉर्निंग,
वेलकम
वेलकम
टू
टू
द
द
लेक्चर
लेक्चर सीरीज
सीरीज
ऑन
ऑन डिजिटल
डिजिटल
इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स
इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स
1883
1883
एंड 83,
एंड
एंड
दिस
दिस
इज
इज
द
द
फोर्थ
फोर्थ
लेक्चर.
लेक्चर.
एंड
एंड
हियर
हियर
इन
इन
दिस
दिस
लेक्चर
लेक्चर
वी
वी
आर
आर
गोइंग
गोइंग
टू
टू
डिस्कस
डिस्कस
हाउ
हाउ
टू
टू
कन्वर्ट
कन्वर्ट
ए
ए
गिवन
गिवन
डेसिमल
डेसिमल
नंबर
नंबर
इनटू
इनटू
हेक्साडेसिमल
हेक्साडेसिमल
नंबर
नंबर
एंड
एंड
वाइस
वाइस
वर्सा.
वर्सा.
दैट
दैट
इज
इज
फ्रॉम
फ्रॉम
डेसिमल
डेसिमल
नंबर
नंबर
गिवन
गिवन
डेसिमल
डेसिमल
नंबर
नंबर
टू
टू
इट्स
इट्स
इक्वल
इक्वल
एंड
एंड
हेक्साडेसिमल
हेक्साडेसिमल
नंबर
नंबर
एंड
एंड
गिवन
गिवन
हेक्साडेसिमल
हेक्साडेसिमल
नंबर
नंबर
टू
टू
इट्स
इट्स
इक्वल
इक्वल
एंड
एंड
डेसिमल
डेसिमल
नंबर.
नंबर.
एंड
एंड
ऑल्सो
ऑल्सो
विल
विल
सी
सी
फ्यू
फ्यू
मोर
मोर
कन्वर्शंस
कन्वर्शंस
कन्वर्टिंग
कन्वर्टिंग
ए
ए
गिवन
गिवन
बाइनरी
बाइनरी
नंबर
नंबर
इनटू
इनटू
ऑक्टल
ऑक्टल
सिस्टम.
सिस्टम.
एंड
एंड
ऑल्सो
ऑल्सो
कन्वर्टिंग
कन्वर्टिंग
ए
ए
गिवन
गिवन
बाइनरी
बाइनरी
नंबर
नंबर
टू
टू
हेक्साडेसिमल
हेक्साडेसिमल
नंबर
नंबर
सिस्टम
सिस्टम
एंड
एंड
वाइस
वाइस
वर्सा.
वर्सा.
So
So
these
these
conversions
conversions
that
that
we'll
we'll
look
look
in
in
this
this
lecture.
lecture.
So
So
first
first
we'll
we'll
deal
deal
with
with
the
the
conversion
conversion
of
of
the
the
decimal
decimal
number
number
to
to
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
number
number
system
system
and
and
vice
vice
versa.
versa.
So
So
at
at
first
first
we'll
we'll
see
see
how
how
to
to
convert
convert
a
a
given
given
decimal
decimal
number
number
given
given
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
number
number
to
to
a
a
decimal
decimal
system.
system.
So,
So,
so
so
far
far
we
we
have
have
seen
seen
the
the
conversion
conversion
of
of
any
any
number
number
from
from
decimal
decimal
to
to
binary
binary
and
and
decimal
decimal
to
to
octal
octal
and
and
vice
vice
versa.
versa.
And
And
also
also
we
we
have
have
seen
seen
that
that
the
the
procedure
procedure
is
is
similar
similar
for
for
all
all
these
these
except
except
the
the
change
change
in
in
the
the
base
base
for
for
each
each
number
number
system.
system.
And
And
here
here
also,
also,
when
when
we
we
are
are
going
going
to
to
convert
convert
the
the
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
to
to
decimal
decimal
conversion,
conversion,
the
the
method
method
or
or
the
the
basic
basic
principle
principle
is
is
same,
same,
that
that
how
how
we
we
do
do
it
it
means
means
we'll
we'll
take
take
each
each
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
digit
digit
and
and
multiply
multiply
it
it
with
with
its
its
corresponding
corresponding
position
position
value,
value,
and
and
we'll
we'll
sum
sum
up
up
all
all
the
the
products
products
to
to
get
get
the
the
equivalent
equivalent
decimal
decimal
number.
number.
But
But
here
here
the
the
positional
positional
values
values
will
will
be
be
powers
powers
of
of
16
16
as
as
it
it
is
is
a
a
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
number.
number.
And
And
you
you
can
can
recap
recap
that
that
the
the
positional
positional
values
values
will
will
be
be
powers
powers
of
of
16
16
to
to
the
the
right
right
side
side
of
of
the
the
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
point.
point.
The
The
powers
powers
will
will
be
be
16
16
power
power
minus
minus
1,
1,
16
16
power
power
minus
minus
2,
2,
16
16
power
power
minus
minus
3,
3,
and
and
so
so
on
on
as
as
we
we
move
move
towards
towards
right
right
side.
side.
Away
Away
from
from
the
the
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
point,
point,
and
and
the
the
positional
positional
values
values
will
will
be
be
16
16
power
power
0,
zero,
16
16
power
power
1,
one,
16
16
power
power
2,
two,
16
16
power
power
3,
3,
and
and
so
so
on
on
as
as
we
we
move
move
away
away
from
from
the
the
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
point
point
towards
towards
left
left
side.
side.
So
So
what
what
you
you
have
have
to
to
do
do
in
in
order
order
to
to
get
get
decimal
decimal
equivalent
equivalent
of
of
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
number,
number,
you
you
have
have
to
to
take
take
the
the
digit
digit
and
and
multiply
multiply
the
the
digit
digit
with
with
its
its
corresponding
corresponding
position
position
value.
value.
It
It
is
is
in
in
this
this
ones
ones
unit
unit
space
space
or
or
16
16
space
space
or
or
256
256
space.
space.
You have to
Take
take
that
that
digit,
digit,
multiply
multiply
that
that
with
with
its
its
position
position
value.
value.
So
So
we
we
will
will
see
see
this
this
procedure
procedure
by
by
taking
taking
an
an
example.
example.
So
So here
here
the
the
example
example
is
is
convert
convert
the
the
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
number
number
to
to
AF
AF
dot
dot
C1
C1
to
to
an
an
equivalent
equivalent
decimal.
decimal.
So
So
here
here
this
this
is
is
an
an
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
number.
number.
You
You
know
know
that
that
the
the
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
number
number
may
may
contain
contain
any
any
of
of
the
the
digits
digits
from
from
0
0
to
to
F.
F.
So
So
these
these
are
are
all
all
the
the
valid
valid
digits.
digits.
So
So
it's
it's
a
a
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
number.
number.
So
So
then
then
how
how
to
to
convert
convert
this?
this?
So
So
we'll
we'll
start
start
with
with
we'll start with the example.
example.
Start
Start
with
with
the
the
example.
example.
Starting
Starting
from
from
the
the
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
point,
point,
as
as
we
we
move
move
towards
towards
right,
right,
We have
have
the
the
digit,
digit, the
the
C.
C. And
And whenever
whenever
we
we
want
want
to
to
find
find
out
out
the
the
value
value
of
of
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
number,
number,
replace
replace
the
the
alphabets
alphabets
with
with
their
their
equivalent
equivalent
values.
values.
And
And
12
12
is
is
the
the
equivalent
equivalent
number
number
for
for
C.
C.
So,
So,
C
C
is
is
equal
equal
to
to
12,
12,
and
and
its
its
position
position
value,
value,
as
as
it
it
is
is
just
just
towards
towards
right
right
of
of
your
your
decimal,
decimal,
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
point,
point,
its
its
position
position
value
value
is
is
16
16
power
power
minus
minus
1.
1.
So
So,
the
the
product
product
is
is
12
12
into
into
16
16
power
power
minus
minus
1.
1.
And
And
the
the
next
next
digit
digit
is
is
1.
1.
And
And
its
its
position
position
value
value
is
is
16
16
power
power
minus
minus
1.
1.
So
So
1
1
into
into
16
16
power
power
minus
minus
2.
2.
Position
Position
value
value
is
is
16
16
power
power
minus
minus
2.
2.
So
So
it
it
is
is
1
1
into
into
16
16
power
power
minus
minus
2.
2.
And
And
similarly,
similarly,
when
when
you
you
move
move
towards
towards
the
the
left
left
of
of
this
this
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
point,
point,
the
the
first
first
digit
digit
is
is
F.
F.
And
And
the
the
equivalent
equivalent
number
number
value
value
of
of
this
this
F
F
is
is
15.
15.
And
And
its
its
position
position
value
value
is
is
16
16
power
power
0.
0.
So
So
for
for
this,
this,
the
the
product
product
is
is
15
15
into
into
16
16
power
power
0.
0.
And
And
the
the
next
next
digit
digit
is
is
A.
A.
And
And
its
its
equivalent
equivalent
number
number
is
is
10.
10.
And
And
its
its
position
position
value
value
is
is
16
16
power
power
1.
1.
So
So
10
10
multiplied
multiplied
with
with
16
16
power
power
1.
1.
And
And
similarly,
similarly,
the
the
next
next
digit
digit
is
is
2.
2.
And
And
this
this
is
is
the
the
third
third
digit
digit
towards
towards
the
the
left
left
of
of
decimal
decimal
point,
point,
and
and
its
its
position
position
value
value
is
is
16
16
power
power
2.
2.
So
So
multiply
multiply
this
this
2
2
with
with
16
16
power
power
2.
2.
And
And
now
now
simplify
simplify
this
this
calculation.
calculation.
This
This
is
is
2
2
into
into
16
16
power
power
2,
2,
so
so
512.
512.
10
10
into
into
16
16
is
is
160,
160,
and
and
15
15
into
into
16
16
power
power
0
0
is
is
15.
15.
And
And
12
12
by
by
12
12
into
into
16
16
power
power
minus
minus
1
1
is
is
12
12
by
by
16.
16.
And
And
it
it
is
is
3
3
by
by
4,
4,
0.75.
0.75.
So
So
it
it
is
is
1
1
into
into
16
16
power
power
minus
minus
2.
2.
It
It
becomes
becomes
1
1
by
by
256,
256,
and
and
that
that
is
is
approximately
approximately
0.004.
0.004.
And
And
summing
summing
all
all
these
these
products,
products,
we
we
are
are
going
going
to
to
get
get
687.754.
687.754.
And this
This
is
is
the
the
equivalent
equivalent
decimal
decimal
number
number
for
for
the
the
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
number
number
to
to
AF.31.
AF.31.
And
And
this
this
is
is
the
the
way
way
how
how
you
you
convert
convert
a
a
given
given
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
number
number
into
into
its
its
equivalent
equivalent
decimal.
decimal.
So
So
the
the
procedure
procedure
is
is
simple,
simple,
the
the
method
method
is
is
simple
simple
as
as
that
that
of
of
the
the
previous,
previous,
as
as
we
we
have
have
seen
seen
the
the
previous
previous
conversions.
conversions.
That
That
you
you
need
need
to
to
multiply
multiply
each
each
and
and
every
every
digit
digit
with
with
its
its
corresponding
corresponding
position
position
value
value
and
and
sum
sum
of
of
all
all
the
the
products,
products,
and
and
you
you
are
are
going
going
to
to
get
get
the
the
decimal
decimal
number,
number,
equivalent
equivalent
decimal
decimal
number.
number.
So
So
in
in
the
the
next
next
slide,
slide,
we'll
we'll
see
see
the
the
reverse
reverse
operation,
operation,
that
that
is
is
from
from
converting
converting
a
a
decimal
decimal
number
number
to
to
decimal
decimal
number
number
to
to
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
system.
system.
So
So
this
this
we'll
we'll
see
see
in
in
two
two
different
different
parts.
parts.
One
One
is
is
where
where
the
the
decimal
decimal
number
number
has
has
doesn't
doesn't
have
have
any
any
fractional
fractional
part,
part,
and
and
the
the
second
second
one
one
is
is
what
what
if
if
the
the
decimal
decimal
number
number
has
has
the
the
fractional
fractional
part.
part.
So
So
in
in
the
the
first
first
place,
place,
we'll
we'll
see
see
converting
converting
a
a
decimal
decimal
number
number
to
to
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
system,
system,
where
where
the
the
decimal
decimal
has
has
decimal
decimal
is
is
only
only
decimal
decimal
number
number
is
is
only
only
an
an
integer.
integer.
So
So
what
what
you
you
have
have
to
to
do,
do,
the
the
similar
similar
repeated
repeated
division
division
method
method
is
is
used,
used,
but
but
here
here
the
the
repeated
repeated
division
division
is
is
to
to
be
be
done
done
by
by
the
the
base
base
of
of
hexadecimal
hexadecimal
number
number
system,
system,
which
which
is
is
16.
16.
So
So
take
take
the
the
decimal
decimal
number
number
that
that
you
you
want
want
to
to
convert
convert
and
and
divide
divide
it
it
by
by
continuously
continuously
16.
16.
And
And
as
as
you
you
divide,
divide,
collect
collect
the
the
remainders.
remainders.
And
And
the
the
division
division
should
should
continue
continue
until
until
you
you
get
get
a
a
zero
zero
quotient.
quotient.
And
And
the
the
first
first
remainder
remainder
that
that
we
we
got
got
becomes
becomes
the
the
LSD,
LSD,
least
least
significant
significant
digit
digit
of
of
the
the
result.
result.
And
And
the
the
last
last
remainder
remainder
we
we
got
got
is
is
will
will
become
become
the
the
most
most
significant
significant
digit
digit
of
of
the
the
result.
result.
So
So
we'll
we'll
illustrate
illustrate
this
this
with
with
an
an
example
example
here.
here.
So
So
the
the
example
example
is
is
convert
convert
the
the
decimal
decimal
number
number
423
423
into
into
hexadecimal.
hexadecimal.
So
So
here
here
shows
shows
how
how
we have
we have
actually
actually
did
did
the
the
repeated
repeated
division.
division. to find out the hexadecimal equivalent. So 423 divided by 16. So 16 to the 32 and 1 add 16 to the 96. So the remainder is a 7. 7 is to be written as LSD, least significant digit. The next to this 26 becomes
is to be divided by 16.
By 16 again, and this time the quotient is 1 and the remainder is 10. But you can see that the remainder is 10. But 10 is represented in hexadecimal by the letter capital A. So the remainder 10 is to be written as A in the result. And similarly, the new quotient is 1 and this 1 should be divided by 16, and this time we are going to get a 0 as the quotient and remainder as 1. And this is the last remainder because we want the quotient as 0. So this last remainder must be written as most significant digit. So this ends, this will be the end of the conversion. And now this decimal number 423 is equal to 1A7 in hexadecimal. So this is how the same similar procedure to as that of decimal to binary and decimal to octal conversion. The only change is we are dividing the decimal number by 16 continuously, repeatedly here. So next we'll see what if the decimal number also contains a fractional part. So here the decimal to hexa conversion where the decimal number also has a fractional part. So this will illustrate with an example. So convert the decimal number 423.75 to hexadecimal. And the method is as we have seen the previous number systems. Whenever you are to convert a decimal number with fractional part into a different number system, what you have to do? You have to do it, you have to do the conversion separately for the integer part and separately for the fraction part. Because for the integer part, the procedure is repeated division, and for the fractional part, the procedure is repeated multiplication. So since the procedures are different, you have to separately convert the integer part and fraction part, and you have to combine the result. So here, when you separate the integer part is 423. The integer part can be converted to hexadecimal by using repeated division as we did in the previous slide. That is 423 decimal number, when it is converted by using repeated division into hexadecimal, you will get the result as 1A7. So that we have taken from the previous slide directly. You will get 187. Then you will see the fractional part. What about the fractional part? Fractional part is 0.75, and this fractional part is converted to hexadecimal by multiplying the fractional part with sixteen, the base of hexadecimal. The base of hexadecimal system. So take the fractional part 0.75 and multiply 8 with 16, and whenever you multiply, each time you separate the integer part and take the fractional part to the next step for multiplication again by 16, and you continue in this way until you get integer part as 0. And the first integer part becomes a digit after the hexadecimal point, and the last integer part becomes a least significant digit of the number. So here you can see 0.75 is the fractional part in our example. So take 0.75 multiplied with 16, we'll get 12.0, and the integer part is 12. So we have separated this, but In hexadecimal, this 12 is represented by the letter capital C. So we'll write C for this 12. And next, apart separating this integer part from 12.0, the remaining fraction part is 0.0, which is again multiplied with 16. The result is 0.0, and in this integer part is 0. So since we got the integer part as 0, we'll stop the multiplication, and the result of result is it is 0.c. 0.c 0 actually. So that can be written as 0.c. Now that 0.c is the equivalent, the hexadecimal equivalent of the decimal fraction 0.75. So we got the result conversion for integer part, which is for 423 it is 187, and for fraction part 0.75 it is 0.c. So we'll combine these two. We'll combine these two to see what is the equivalent value of the total decimal number that we want to convert, that is 423.75. So we'll combine these two results. So the hexadecimal equivalent of 423.75 becomes 187.c. And this is how we convert the numbers from hexadecimal to decimal and decimal to hexadecimal. So for hexadecimal to decimal conversion, we'll use we'll take the individual digits and multiply them with the corresponding position values, and we'll add up all those products to get the decimal equivalent. And for decimal to hexa conversion, there is no fraction part, then we'll go with the repeated division of the given decimal number by 16. And if there is a fraction part, we'll take that fraction part and we'll multiply the fraction by repeatedly by 16, and we'll collect the integers. So in the next slide, we'll discuss how to convert a given octal number to binary system. Binary number system. We'll also see the reverse operation. And why? What is the need of octal system? We have seen earlier that it is used to represent the binary numbers compactly. So that means representing the same number in octal takes less number of digits, and it is less error prone compared to representing the binary numbers when the numbers are dealt with dealt by humans. So here we'll see conversion of given octal number to binary system. So the procedure is very simple. What you have to do is, whenever you find an octal in the given octal number, you replace each octal digit with its 3-bit binary equivalent. Replace each digit of the octal number with its 3-bit binary equivalent. And you can see that, what is this mean by that, we will see in detail. So, octal number may contain any of the digits from 0 to 7, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 are all the valid digits of any octal number system. So all the octal numbers may contain only these digits from 0 to 7, and for all these octal digits, you can see We have shown the 3-bit binary equivalent of the all these 8 digits. For 0, the 3-bit binary equivalent is 000, and for 1, binary equivalent is 001, and for 2, the binary equivalent is 010, and for 3, the binary equivalent is 011, and for 4, it is 100, and 5, it is 101, and for 6, it is 110, and for 7, it is 111. Right. So these are the 3-bit binary equivalent of all the 8 octal digits, and whenever you find whenever you are given with octal digit, then replace if you may find any of these 8 digits in octal number. So in order to convert the octal number to binary, so if you find 3, then you have to replace 3 with 011 to convert that octal number to binary. Similarly, if you find some 6 octal digit doctor number, you have to replace it with 110 and so on. So we illustrate this with an example. So here the example is to convert doctor number 478. Convert doctor number 478 to binary. So what is the procedure? We have sorry, this is not 478, it is 472. It is 472. So convert the octal number 472 binary. So that means, what is the procedure? The procedure is observe all the digits of the octal number, given octal number, and find its 3-bit binary equivalent from this table. So you have first digit MSB is 4, and what is the 3-bit binary equivalent? It is 100. So here we have shown in detail for 4, the 3-bit binary equivalent is 100, and for 7. The 3-bit binary equivalent is 111, and for 2, 3-bit binary equivalent is 010. So write all these bits continuation for 4, 100, and for 7, 111, and for 2, 010, and this becomes the equivalent binary number for the given octal number 472. Right, so very clear and very simple. Just you have to replace like a octal digit with its 3-bit binary equivalent. So always replace the octal digit only with 3-bit binary equivalent. So that means if it is 0, means should write 3 zeros. Should not write only 10 or 20s. You should always write 3 zeros. And 1 means you have to write the 001. Right? So on. And next, here we go with another example. Convert 561.26, the octal number, to binary. And same, procedure is same. So 561, we identify the various digits. And we are replacing now 5 with its binary equivalent, 3 with binary 101, 6 with 110, and 1 with 001. And point, we have to carry the point to the result, and 2 is 010, and 6 is 110. Now you combine all these bits, write in sequence 101, 110. 001.010110, and this becomes the binary equivalent of the octal number 561.26. So very simple method, that just you need to replace
Each octal digit with its 3-bit binary equivalent, when you want to convert a given octal number to binary system. So next we will see the reverse case, that conversion of a binary number to octal number. Conversion of a binary number to octal number. So here also we will see this how what is the procedure for conversion in two different cases. In the first case we will see the binary number doesn't have any fraction part, then how to convert it to octal. And the second case we will see if the binary number has a fraction part, then how to convert it to octal number. So we will go with the first case one first. That is, here we will take the binary number with only integer part, and we will see how to convert it. So if you are given with any binary number that is to be converted into octal, you group the bits into groups of three, right? So you take look at the binary number and you start grouping the bits into groups of three, starting with the least significant bit, that is the rightmost bit. Then each group will contain how many bits? Each group will contain 3 bits only. And you know that for a 3-bit binary equivalent, what is the octal digit? What is the octal digit from the previous slide as shown here? Right? So here you will be grouping. So for binary to octal number conversion, you are observing all the bits and you are grouping the bits into groups of 3. And when you are forming a group of 3 binary bits, you know what is its hexadecimal, what is its octal equivalent, that you can know from this table. So for each 3-bit binary, you replace that 3 bits with its equivalent octal digit. So that gives you finally the octal number equivalent to a given binary number. So this we will see with by looking at an example to convert, how to convert there. So convert, we are given with one binary number 1010 and 10001 to octal. So here we have how many bits are there? Here we have 9 bits are there. So that means we can perfectly form into groups of 3. That means we are going to get 3 groups. And from where we have to start forming the group? Start with the LSB, that is least significant bit or the rightmost bit. So the starting with this rightmost bit 100 form the first group. And after that 010 forms the second group. And next 101 forms the third group. And from the previous table it is very clear that 001 is the 3-bit binary equivalent of the octal digit 1. Again, 001 is the octal binary equivalent of the octal digit 1. In a similar way, 010 is the 3-bit binary equivalent of the octal digit 2, and 101 is the 3-bit binary equivalent of the octal digit 5. So replace these three groups of bits with their equivalent octal digit. So now you got 521, and this is a equivalent octal number for this given binary number. So now this binary number, here we can observe one thing, and that the binary number we have taken has in total 9 bits, and so we can form exactly 3 groups. But what if we can't form groups of 3 bits, and some of the group may don't have sufficient bits to form group of 3. That means if you have, say for example, 8, or if you have total number of bits in the binary number, say 8, that means we can form two groups with 3 bits each, and the last group has only 2 bits. And what is the value of the third bit that you have to consider? And also, what if the given binary number has some 10 bits? That means we can form groups, 3 groups of 3 bits each, and only 1 bit is left. So how to form a group with that only one particular remaining bit? So what you have to do is, when there are no sufficient bits to form groups of 3, you have to add 1 or 2 zeros. You have to add 1 or 2 zeros to the left of the LSB. Anyway, we will be starting forming the groups from LSB. From LSB is significant bit. So if the bits are not sufficient, that group will be related to your MSB. So how many bits are less in number, you add that many zeros to the left of your MSB. So we'll take an example and we'll show how this can be done. So here, convert the given binary number 101101 to octal. And here you can see how many number of bits are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have only 7 bits in this binary number, but still we have to form groups of 3. So we will again start with the LSB to form the groups. We will start at the LSB. So 101 becomes the first group, and 110 becomes the second group, and we are left with only the MSB bit 1, but still we have to form a group of 3. So 2 bits are less in number. So what you have to do? To the left of this MSB 1, you add 2 zeros to get a group of 3. So its value will not change as you placed zeros before it. So 001 will be the in group of 3 after adding 2 zeros before your to the left of your MSB. So after adding this, we now got 3 groups with 3 bits each. Now look at the table to find out what is the octal equivalent of these 3 groups of 3 bits. So for 001, the octal equivalent digit is 1, and for 011, you can see, for 011, the equivalent octal digit is 3. Equivalent octal digit is 3. And for 101, the equivalent octal digit is 5. So we write 5 here. So 1, 3, and 5. So 135 becomes our octal equivalent number for the given binary number 101101. So the basic method to convert a given binary number to octal number is, take the binary number and starting at the MSB, start forming groups of 3 bits as you go towards MSB. And when there are not sufficient bits to form groups of 3, then what you have to do? You add the required number, that is 1 or 2 zeros, to the left of MSB, so that you get. You can see that all the groups should contain 3 bits. So if the group associated with the image B doesn't have sufficient bits, what you are doing? You are adding the required number of zeros to the left of images so that that group also contains 3 bits. And when you got these groups of 3 bits, what you have to do? You have to find, for every group of 3 bits, you have to find the equivalent octal digit.
Equivalent octal digit. And replace the group with the corresponding octal digit so that you will get the octal equivalent octal number. And in the second case, we'll see what if the binary number that is to be converted into octal system contains a fraction part also. Fraction part also. So it has a binary point also. So here what you have to do is the procedure is similar, that is you have to form again the groups of 3 bits, and for each group you have to replace the group with its equivalent octal digit, but from where you have to, from which point you have to start forming the groups of 3 bits. So here, whenever you have a binary number with fraction part, start forming the groups of 3 bits starting from the binary point. Starting from the binary point, as you are moving towards right side, that is your LSB, you start collecting the bits into groups of 3. And if there are no sufficient bits to form a group, you can add the required number of zeros to the right of LSB. To the right of LSB. And similarly, you again form the groups of 3 bits as you move towards left of the binary point. So as you move towards the left of the binary point, that is towards MSB, you start collecting 3 bits and make them into a group, and you move towards MSB. And if for the group associated with MSB, if the bits are not sufficient, you add the required number of zeros, or you place the 1 or 2 zeros to the left of your most significant bit. So we will clearly show that this with an example. So here the example, convert the given binary number 1011.11 to octal. So what we have to do here, we'll start with the binary point. And as we'll start forming groups of 3 bits for the fractional part, that is as we move towards right. So as we move towards right, we have to collect 3 bits and form a group. And you can see towards the right of this binary point, we have only 2 bits. We have only 2 bits. So to make a group of 3 bits, 1 bit is less. So what you have to do? You have to put a 0 to the right of LSB. To the right of LSB. And by considering that 0, you can make a group of 3 bits, that is 110. So 110 becomes a group after adding 0 to the right of LSB. And keep the binary point as is, and you start moving to the left, that is your towards MSB. So here, as you move, you collect 3 bits at a time and make them into one group. So 110, so here 3 bits here. So 110 is the one group of 3 bits. And after this, you can see that you have only 1 bit 1. And this is MSB. So to form one more group, 2 bits are less in number. So what you have to do? You have to add 2 zeros to the left of MSB. to make it a group of 3 bits. So here 001 after adding 2 zeros to the left of MSB, it becomes 001, and this will form another group of 3 bits. So now what you have to do, for every group of 3 bits, 3 binary bits, you find the equivalent octal digit and replace these 3 binary bits with its octal digit. 001, the equivalent octal digit is 1, and 011, the equivalent octal digit is 3, and carry this point, it becomes a decimal point, octal point here, and 110. For 110, the equivalent octal digit is 6. So this is how we convert a given binary number into octal. A given binary number into octal. So the procedure is very simple. If the binary number doesn't have any fraction part, what you have to do? You start collecting the bits starting at the LSB, and you collect the bits 3 and form them into a group. And if the bits are not sufficient to make a group of 3, you add zeros to the left of LSB, and for each group of 3 bit binary, you find the equivalent octal digit and replace that group of 3 bits with its equivalent octal digit. So what if the binary number has a fractional part? What do you have to do? You start at the binary point, and as you move towards LSB, you form group of 3 bits. And if the bits are not sufficient, you place zeros to the right of LSB, and similarly you form groups of 3 bits for the integer part also. And when the bits are not sufficient, place the required number of zeros to the left of MSB, and after you got all the groups of 3 bits, what you have to do? Find the equivalent octal digit for every group and replace the group with its equivalent octal digit. And this is how we convert the binary number to octal. And this completes our binary to octal and octal to binary conversion. And quickly we look at the remaining thing, that is conversion from hexadecimal to binary and binary numbers to hexadecimal, right? So this procedure is very similar as to that of your binary to octal and octal to binary conversion. So now we are looking at how to convert a given decimal number to binary system. What you have to do?
So hexadecimal number system means the valid digits are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F. And each hexadecimal digit can be written as a 4-bit binary number. 4-bit equivalent binary number. That means 0 can be written as 0, 0, 0, 0. And 1 can be written as 0001. Similarly, 2 can be written as 0010. Similarly, F can be written as 1111. So all hexadecimal digits can be written with their binary equivalent, 4-bit binary equivalent. Here you have to see whether it is necessary to place the zeros, whether it is necessary to use all 4 bits. That is immaterial, whether they are zeros or not. You have to write, represent that hexadecimal digit with its 4-bit binary. So for example, 0, hexadecimal digit should be replaced with 0000, 4 bits only. Right? So
So the procedure is similar. When we have converted octal to binary, we replaced each octal digit with its 3-bit binary equivalent. Now here, when you want to convert hexadecimal number to binary system, what you have to do?
So hexadecimal number means it may contain any of these hexadecimal digits,
and whatever the hexadecimal digit that you find in the given number, replace that digit with its 4-bit binary equivalent. And after you replace all the digits with the 4-bit binary equivalent, that becomes the binary equivalent of the given hexadecimal number.
For example, if you find
5 hexadecimal digit in the number, hexadecimal number, you have to replace 5 with 0101. Similarly, whatever all the digits you find in the number, you have to replace them with their 4-bit binary equivalent. So we'll see an example quickly. So convert 47E. This is an hexadecimal number. So all these are valid digits from hexadecimal. Convert 47E to binary. So the first hexadecimal digit is 4. So find its 4-bit binary equivalent 0100. So now replace 4 with 0100. Similarly, 7, its hexadecimal equivalent is 0111. So replace 7 with 0111. And E is the hexadecimal digit. So find its 4-bit binary equivalent for E, it is 1110. So replace E with 1110. So write all these bits in sequence 0100 and 0111. And 1110, and this becomes the binary equivalent of the hexadecimal number 47E. So very simple here. For each hexadecimal digit, you will be replacing the digit with its 4-bit binary equivalent. And these are the 4-bit binary equivalents for all the hexadecimal digits that we are showing in the slide. So next we'll see one more example. So convert A1 0.2C to binary. The similar procedure we can adopt. The similar procedure we can convert this hexadecimal number to binary for A. So where is A? For A it is 1010. So replace A with 1010. For 1, replace its 4-bit binary equivalent 0001. And for 2, 0010. And for C, it is 1100. Keep this point as this. So now write all this, combine all these bits. So 1010 0001 dot 0010 and 1100, and this becomes the equivalent binary for a given hexadecimal number A1.2C. So this is how we will convert the given hexadecimal number to binary. So for each hexadecimal digit, replace it with a 4-bit binary equivalent. So very simple, easy to understand. And next we will see the reverse conversion procedure, that is from binary to hexadecimal number. And this also we will see in two different parts. The case one is if the binary number doesn't have any fraction part. So that means only integer binary we will be converting. In case 2, we will be seeing what if the binary number has fraction part also. So first we will see binary number with no fraction part. So you are given with a binary number and you have to convert it to hexadecimal number, this one. So what you have to do here, again, the procedure is 2. Start with the LSB, least significant bit of the binary number, and start collecting 4 bits and form it into a group. So starting with the LSB, you start collecting 4 bits and to make them into a group. And if the bits are not sufficient, what you have to do? You add the required number of zeros to the left of MSB. And now this each group of 4 bits must be replaced with its hexadecimal equivalent digit, that is from the previous slide we have shown. So you will be forming groups of 4 bits. So after getting groups of 4 bits, for each group of 4 bits you have the corresponding equivalent hexadecimal digit is there. So you have to replace the groups of 4 bits by its hexadecimal digit. So we'll see that by taking an example. So convert 1010 1110 001. We are taking an example. Here the example is to convert the binary number 1010 1111 0001. This is a binary number, so you have to convert it to hexadecimal. So what you have to do, start at the LSB, least significant bit, and collect 4 bits and make it into a separate group. So 1000 becomes the first group. And next 1111 becomes a sorry. The number to be converted is 1010 0111 0001. This is to be converted to hexadecimal. So what you have to do, start at LSB, start collecting 4 bits at a time. So 1000 is the first group of 4 bits, and next 1110 is the next group of 4 bits, and next 0101 is the next group of 4 bits. So there are no bits left, so we got only 3 groups. And for each group, you find what is its hexadecimal equivalent digit. So for 1010, you can see that here 1010, the equivalent hexadecimal digit is A. So replace this group with A. And similarly, 0111, for 0111, the hexadecimal digit is 7. So replace this 0111 with 7. And similarly, 0001, for this 4 bit binary, the hexadecimal digit is equivalent digit is 1. So replace this group with 1. After replacing all the group with the hexadecimal digit, equivalent digits, you got the result as A71. And this becomes the hexadecimal equivalent of the given binary number. So we will take one more example, example number 2. And here we have one more binary number given, 1011101. And this we need to convert to hexadecimal. The procedure is similar. You start collecting the bits 4 bit at a time and form them into group. So 1011 is the first group. So 1011 is the first group, and after that you have 3 bit, only 3 bits left. 101, only 3 bits are left. So one more bit is required to make it a group of 4. So write 0 to the left of MSB. So then it also becomes a group of 4 bits. Now find the hexadecimal equivalent for this 0101, it is 5 from the previous table shown, and for 1101, the hexadecimal digit is D. So now 5D is the hexadecimal number equivalent to the given binary. So this is how we convert binary number to hexadecimal number if there is no fraction mark. Next, we'll see the second case where we say that if the binary number has a fractional part, then how to convert it to hexadecimal. So the procedure is same. You have to form groups of 4 bits, and for each group of 4 bits, you replace that group with its equivalent hexadecimal digit. But from where to start to form the groups of 4 bits, that is different when the binary number has a fractional part. So when the binary number has a fractional part, stand at the binary point and farm, try to start farming in groups of 4 bits starting at the binary point for the fraction part. And if the bits are not sufficient, you add zeros to the right of LSB. And similarly, you start at the binary point and start farming the groups of 4 bits for the integer part. And if the bits are not sufficient, you place the required number of zeros to the left of LSB. So we will take this with the help of explain, with this help of an example. So convert the binary number 10111.11 to hexadecimal. So here you have to start from the groups. You have to start at the binary point, and here the binary point, and we'll try to form the group for fractional part first. So from the binary point, as we move towards left, towards right, we have only one, only 2 bits are there. So to form a group of 4 bits, we require 2 more bits. So we'll add 2 zeros to the left, to the right of the LSB. So after adding 2 zeros to the right of LSB, we got a group of 4 bits, so 1100. And next we'll move to the integer part, and here we move to the integer part. And here you can see starting in this binary point 1110 are the 4 bits which can be made into one group. And next you see only 1 bit is left, so to make a group of 4 bits, 3 more bits are required. So you add 3 zeros to the left of MSB. So after adding 3 zeros to the left of MSB, you will get another group of 4 bits. Now all the groups contain 4 bits, so what you have to do? Replace each group with its equivalent hexadecimal digit. For 0001, digit hexadecimal digit is 1. For 0111, equivalent hexadecimal digit is 7. And for 1100, you can see 1100, the equivalent hexadecimal digit is 6. So replace this group with 6. And 17.C is the hexadecimal equivalent of this binary number. So this is how we convert a binary, given binary number, to hexadecimal number system. So by this we have completed, we have seen so far, discussed all the 4 number systems, including the usual and very famous decimal number system. And we did conversion from every system, every number system to the other number system. So that is from decimal to binary, and decimal to hexadecimal, and decimal to octal, and vice versa. And also we have seen how to convert a given binary to octal, and given binary to hexadecimal, and vice versa. So with this we will complete, we have finished all the concepts related to number systems. So in the next lecture we will look at few more basics that are required for digital electronics. Thank you.